Welcome back. No need for an oversized truck or even a car. A bicycle is needed for an upcoming food donation event. Join us to explain what Cranksgiving is all about is Jenny White, co-owner of Velo City Cycles in Holland. Good morning.
Good morning.
I love this. Okay, so what exactly is Cranksgiving?
Yeah, so Cranksgiving, it is a bike ride or bike race. It's a scavenger hunt and it's a food drive all in one. We've been doing, this is our eighth year holding a Cranksgiving event. Past years, what we do is everyone meets at Velo and we hand out instructions and kind of the guidelines for the scavenger hunt. And then we send people all over town collecting food and items for local charities. In the past, we've gathered for the Holland Rescue Mission and also the Community Action House, and this year is Community Action House. Everyone goes out, collects their items, and then comes back to Velo, and we gather all the food and collect it in our big trailer, and then we donate it. This year, it is going to look quite a bit different, though. We are doing more of a DIY or do-it-yourself type event. We will be handing out food checklists or like a food shopping list. We have that already. We have them at the shop and we have them on our website. And we're just sending people out. Go bike around town, collect these items that are needed. And we are collecting them on Saturday at the Community Action House from 10:30 to noon on Saturday. It's just a fun way to get people out on bikes, out in the community, and biking for others. There are a lot of people who need food, and this is a small thing that we can do in a fun way and an active way for our community.
And that is coming up this Saturday. The weather looks like it's going to be in your favor, too.
It looks awesome. This whole week looks great. So I'm encouraging people, just start now. Take a bike ride this afternoon and go to your local grocery store and start collecting food. And it doesn't have to be a lot of food. We do have on our list of our shopping list, kind of a recommended thing that Community Action House has given us of foods that they need. But people can collect all of the food or they can collect a little bit of the food. It all is appreciated. In the past, we've done prizes for youngest competitor, for the most food collected by weight, for the fastest rider, which is really fun. And we'll definitely do that again in the future. But this year, it's just all about collecting food. And that's the goal, the most food that we can collect by bike.
And if someone actually doesn't want to be part of the cycling part of it, but they want to maybe put some food out for someone to donate, is there a way they can do that or participate in that fashion?
Yep, for sure. If they want to just swing by Community Action House this Saturday, the address is 345 West 14th Street in Holland. Just swing by 10:30 to noon on Saturday, and volunteers will be there to help collect and box up the food for people. Social distancing will be enforced, and we will be wearing masks and being careful. So, yeah. I mean, even if you're dropping by in a car, the goal is to get people out on bikes, but the more food, the better.
And this year, more than ever, I bet you a lot of people could really use that extra little help.
Yep.
All right. Well, we appreciate what you're doing. I love the fact we hear so much the things we can't do. So this is one thing we can get out and do, everybody. So again, Cranksgiving is happening November 7th. The Community Action House is where all the donations are going to end up there from 10:30 to noon. Go to velo-citycycles.com for more information. We're going to get all of these details on our website at fox17morningmix.com. Thanks for your time this morning.